You used to be something. They used to fear you. They'd hide anywhere their small, shivering bodies would fit. Little errand boy. That's nice.
Ah, Bigby. I see you made it here in one piece. I do apologize, but I have some business to attend to. I leave you in the capable hands of my associate. Come find me when you finish, dear.
Don't worry. This won't take long.
Get out of my way now. Don't make this worse.
Aw, he doesn't want to play.
I'm sure you'll persuade him.
Cut this shit out!
Didn't your mother ever teach you manners? Or was she too busy fucking whatever breeze drifted through town? Oh, come on! Is that the best you can do?
Ah!
Hello, Bigby. You look tired.
Give me one good reason not to rip you apart right now.
This gun holds 6 rounds of specially designed silver bullets. Now, I may not be the best shot, but I can guarantee that at least one bolt will meet its mark, and you'll find yourself rolling on the floor in agony, unable to heal yourself. Without Swineheart to save you, you'll die. Is that reason enough for you? Before you do anything with me, I thought I should point out a few things. Snow White wants you to bring me back to the woodlands, doesn't she? And that's what I want.
That's right. But what happens to you once you get there is a different story.
I'm not quite finished. You will bring me back alive. Look, all I ask for is the chance to speak for myself in front of the community. And I'm sure Miss White would agree that I should be given a fair trial. Can we at least agree on that? I will have a trial. Are we clear?
The whole town will be calling for your execution. Why would you want me to bring you back there?
Why don't you let me worry about that? Look, there's no reason for us to be at each other's throats here.
That's funny, coming from a guy pointing a gun at my head.
This is just a precaution. I'm sure you understand. I'm no murderer, Mr. Wolf. I didn't kill those women. And I think you know that. All I'm asking for is a chance to explain my side of the story.
Maybe you didn't carry it out, but I don't think Georgie was lying when he said you ordered their deaths.
Georgie would have said anything to save himself. We both know that. I'm a businessman, not a killer.
There's still a lot you have to answer for.
And I will, as long as you agree to my terms. Because I'm not saying another word until I'm brought before the community. I don't mean to belabor the point, but just so we're clear, if you change your mind and decide to do something stupid, you won't get your answers. But you will have a difficult time explaining yourself to Miss White and the rest of this miserable town. You're often reckless, and I worry you're not thinking of the... Let me ask you an honest question. What do you really care about here? Where this case is concerned, I mean. Do you really want the truth? Or do you just want to look like the hero? Because those are 2 very different things.
This is about justice. I'm the sheriff. I have to do what's right. 2 people were murdered.
And you know who did it. Georgie. He's dead, isn't he? My point being, the killer has been dealt with. You've won.
You really think I'm that stupid?
I understand you have an obligation to bring me in. But you can brighten up a little. It's over. So, shall we get going? I'd rather not dawdle. You know, I'm actually looking forward to seeing Miss White again. My previous interactions with her have gone rather well.
All right, let's go. Hand over the gun.
I think I'd rather hold on to it, if you don't mind. What do you say?
Hey!
I'm sure Miss White will be pleased. Such a reliable pup. I understand why she'd want to keep you around.
You're under arrest. You'll be given a trial in front of your peers. And your punishment will follow.
I know. But we have to do something.
Are you fucking kidding me?
When is this thing happening?
Are we sure he's coming?
Yes, you'll have an opportunity to... He's back.
The crooked man.
Thank God.
Motherfucker.
Are you okay? It's been hours. We were worried you'd run into some trouble. At the Crooked Man's place. And after what happened with Mary...
Well, he didn't make it easy.
What happened?
It doesn't matter. He's here. We got him.
We can talk about it later. You did well, Sheriff. I'm surprised. Not that you did well, but that, you know... I'm just glad you made it back in one piece.
It's about time you showed up. Now throw this asshole down the fucking well.
Yes, what are you waiting for?
You murderer!
My you killed Lily!
She was my sister!
Where the fuck do you get off? You think you have the right to just do this to people? You're a fucking crook!
You should be ashamed. Everyone, can I have your attention?
Thank you all for coming here on such short notice. I know normally we'd schedule a formal hearing, but considering the circumstances, I thought it best if we do this as soon as possible. The Crooked Man is charged with the murder
as
of Faith
and... As I already informed your sheriff, it was Mr. Georgie Porgie who killed those women, not me.
What? It was Georgie?
Georgie?
I don't mean to interrupt you, Miss White, but I thought it would be unwise to proceed with such faulty information.
Bigby, is that true?
Georgie may have killed them. But you made the call.
Do I have to explain the situation to you again?
Wait a minute. So you're saying Georgie's the motherfucker who killed my sister? Well, where is he?
Yeah, you're gonna bring that shithead in too, aren't you?
Yes, Sheriff. Where is that rotten scoundrel now?
Is he still out there?
I sincerely hope not.
Well, where is he?
Sheriff?
I killed him. He's dead.
He's what?
Dead. So you see, the culprit has been punished. There's no
that doesn't change anything. We'll deal with it later, but right now, you're the one I'm concerned with.
You called the shots. Georgie made that perfectly clear.
In which case, you still have a lot to answer for. And
I was told
don't...
I would be allowed to speak.
We have to read the rest of the charges.
What other charges?
If you'd wait a moment.
I'm well aware of my rights, Miss White. Unless you plan to abandon the charter entirely.
Let her finish. Then you can have your say.
Got it?
If you insist.
You are charged with the murder of Faith and Lily, which Georgie carried out on your order, inciting violence against various members of the Fabletown community, including the attempted murder of Sheriff Bigby Wolf.
Twice.
A misunderstanding.
Aiding and providing monetary support for the forced prostitution at the Pudding and Pie. Additionally, you are charged with multiple counts of fraud, extortion, racketeering, and the illegal possession and sale of magical artifacts. Now, is there anything you would like to say?
First of all, I had nothing to do with Faith and Lily, so you can strike that one from your little record book.
Bullshit!
Like hell you
did. Stop the charade. We know you're involved.
Come on, it's obvious.
And there's all the other crap he's done.
Everyone just shut up for a minute. You wanted a chance to talk. Well, go ahead.
What?
We all know he's guilty. What the fuck does he need to speak for?
The Crooked Man has committed crimes against this government and, most importantly, its citizens. These charges, if proven, are enough to justify death, upon which your body will be committed to the witching
where
well.
It fucking belongs.
That's
so
right.
Let's get on
but
with
we
it
promised
then.
You a chance to defend yourself, and I won't rob you of that right.
What the
You're
fuck?
Really going
this
to let
is
him
about
talk?
Justice. If we're ever going to pull ourselves together and make something of this town, we have to start doing things correctly. No more snap judgments, no more secrets. We are going to treat everyone fairly, even when they don't deserve it.
This is ridiculous.
You have the floor.
Thank you, Miss White. You've all met Georgie. I don't have to tell you what kind of person he was. He was a total scoundrel, lacking in any sort of moral fiber. I hired him as a favor to his family, you see. A promise kept to a dying mother.
Oh, jeez.
Are you gonna get to your point or what?
Georgie was working for me, yes. But he was not acting on my behalf when he killed those women. It was his business. And for whatever reason, I'm sure only he could understand, he murdered two of his most faithful employees. I had nothing to do with it.
This is such bullshit!
He's always been a bit of a powder keg. It was only a matter of time before something like this happened.
If you were so offended by it, why'd you cover it up then? If it had nothing to do with you and your shit, then why'd you try to protect him for so long?
What cover-up? I never made any attempt to hide Georgie's criminal activity from you. I learned of it myself
for
only recently.
For fuck's sake. Any of you actually believe this bullshit?
Holly, please.
Tell them, Bigby. When you finally showed up at my door last night, wasn't I more than helpful? I answered your questions. I was willing to cooperate.
What's he talking about?
Yeah, and your goons attacked me. Did you forget that part?
They get a bit carried away sometimes, it's true. Loyal to the end. They do it because they want to protect me, as I protected them. You understand wanting to protect what you care about, don't you? You'd do anything. You might even give up an innocent man, just to save someone.
What's he talking about?
Yeah, right. They don't do it because they want to protect you. You intimidate people. Use scare tactics. They're afraid if they don't follow orders, they'll end up dead.
Let me explain this to you. My employees are just that. Hired help. I see some of them are here among you. They are not my slaves. They are all free to make their own decisions, as Georgie was.
You're not serious! I know what you do to people. I've seen it firsthand. What you did to Faith. The way you manipulated her. Do you really think any of those girls were free? Do you really think Faith wanted to-
I'm sorry, Lawrence. I'm sorry that your wife came to me for help, and I'm sorry that I decided against my best judgment to give her a distasteful job.
Right, and you kept them in debt so they couldn't leave.
Yeah, that's what you did to us. How you kept us all
you
in line.
You forget it was not me who put you in that position. You all act like I'm some kind of tyrant. When your government abandoned you, left you poor and helpless, sniveling on street corners, I was there to look out for you.
Yes, but...
Wasn't I?
Crane was the one who let this town go to the fucking dogs. The guy who was in your pocket, remember?
Really? What about Archie Greenleaf? Her story is not uncommon. She left everything she had back in the homelands. Everything that matters, anyway. With nowhere else to turn, she came to me for help. And what did I do for you?
You got my tree back.
I got her tree back. And in turn, we used her magic to help poor Fables get glamours. Because I helped her, she was able to make a living, provide for herself. And what did they do?
For the longest time, not much. But they asked me to come work for them.
Really? The new deputy mayor wants you on the 13th floor?
No. The wolf offered me the job. She wanted my tree destroyed. If she had had her way, I'd be hung out to dry on a clothesline by now.
What?
You were gonna burn her tree? Snow, why would you want that?
Is that true?
Snow?
Don't blame Snow. She had her reasons. Greenleaf was using her magic to help Crane and the Crooked Man. That's why Snow wanted your tree burned.
That's not why.
It wasn't her fault.
You can lie to yourself, but you can't lie to me. You hated Crane, and you hated him for wanting to fuck you, and you being too soft to notice what he'd do to get it. It had nothing to do with a Crooked Man.
We've made some mistakes. I've made some mistakes. But believe me, I truly want what's best for this town. And that may not always be clear right away. But I want you all to know that I care deeply about all of you. And so does the sheriff.
Yeah, right.
I can't promise you perfection. No one can. But I can promise to always have your best interests at heart.
Like you did with her?
Maybe you haven't noticed, but we've been doing all this to protect you. We're trying to stop people like him.
The Crooked Man's been exploiting you. Exploiting your hope for a better life. You would go to him for help, and he would take that weakness and add it to his strength. And if things didn't fall exactly his way, someone would die.
He took Faith and Lily from us. And while we can never get them back, we can certainly punish who's responsible.
They're right.
You're all still afraid of him, even now. But you needn't be. His contamination of this town is over. And those girls will have their justice.
Very good, very good. The sentiment is surely appreciated, Miss White. But it doesn't disguise the fact that these accusations are completely unfounded. The sheriff simply doesn't have a particle of evidence linking me to the...
Georgie was working for you. Bigby got a confession that...
A confession that nobody heard. Now, I'm no barrister, but I think such a statement would carry more weight if Bigby weren't the only one to whom Georgie spoke. Especially given Bigby's... history.
What are you talking about?
Snow?
You won't be able to talk your way out of this, crooked man.
What do you mean there's no evidence?
Maybe he's... I mean, this doesn't feel right, how we're doing this. I just need...
Of course it's right. This man tormented all of you, for profit. Georgie
Let
killed him.
Let me just make sure I understand you. You're trying to say that I'm responsible for what Georgie did, because he was working for me at the time, yes?
Yes.
Of course. Yes, you're responsible.
Well, by that logic, Miss White should be on trial for Tweedledum's murder, since you know Bigby works for her.
That's...
He killed a man.
That don't make him a murderer.
Doesn't it?
For fuck's sake, killing someone who's trying to kill you is hardly...
They were there to retrieve Crane. You didn't need to escalate things.
Me? It was them. And who sent those two freaks anyway?
Bigby and I have already discussed his behavior that night. We're handling it internally.
Now, where have I heard that before? How about the way he treated poor Tweedledee when he was in your custody? He was beaten to mashed apples while under your watch.
Under my watch?
Maybe he's right.
Did you think we'd all just let that go?
You can't be serious.
That was different.
What? You think you shouldn't be held accountable?
Snow had nothing to do with it. We all thought she was dead.
Besides, Crane was still deputy mayor when that happened. Right before you decided to kidnap him.
It was for his own protection. Oh, you're right, dear. Crane was in charge. Sometimes it's hard to tell the difference.
That's enough.
So, you won't answer for your employee's behavior, but I must perish for
this
mine.
This is completely different.
I did not order those two girls dead. It simply never happened. Georgie killed Faith and Lily. End of story. They want to scapegoat me for their own tangled ends, but they refuse to answer for their own
crimes.
This
isn't right.
Oh, please.
This isn't the point.
We'll deal with them after we deal with you.
Listen, I know...
The laws apply when we need them.
Bluebeard, please.
What's that supposed to mean?
Everyone calm down. This isn't the
reason we're here. I mean, a certain level of privilege should be afforded to them.
This is how it's always been.
This is what I'm talking about. We lashed our ropes to this diseased world, and ever since... Which one of us has been there for you? Who filled your lives with the promise of more? Who was there while they idly played in their towers, judging you, treating you as mindless children, too stupid to command your own destiny? Without me, who will pay your rent when you're on the verge of eviction? Who will dare challenge their brutality when it leaks to our dear citizens? Who will protect you from the big bad wolf? Who will be
Bigby? Miss White!
Excuse me, dear.
I wanted to make sure I had the chance to say something.
Why don't you take a moment to catch your breath, little
What's she doing here?
I'd like to... I need to say something.
We're kind of in the middle of something.
Bluebeard.
What?
Of course. Go right ahead.
You probably don't remember me. I don't know why I was afraid to come here.
My dear, I don't know.
Just shut up. You enslaved us for years. Let us hear stories about what you do. Told us we would lose everything if we stepped just one toe out of line. And we couldn't say a word about it because of these damn ribbons. Hey. But you know what? Now it's my turn to talk.
How are you?
I found Vivian's body. Did you kill her? Did he?
Sheriff, this is highly irregular.
Be quiet.
We need to establish some order here.
Vivian wanted you freed from the ribbons. She took her own life.
I'm sorry, I don't think
I... Nerissa! My name is Nerissa.
It's okay, my dear. It's going to be just...
He ordered them dead. This fucker. Faith and Lily.
That's a lie.
I was in the goddamn room when he did it. Faith and Lily are dead because of you. The only two people who ever gave a damn about me. And now I can finally say, you're an asshole. And I hope you rot at the bottom of the witching well for what you did.
And this just confirms it.
He made Georgie do it. It was always him. Georgie would have never done anything without his say-so. Ever.
You're going to take the word of a stupid...
At least five other girls will back me up on this. We all heard you say it.
Did you now?
Looks like we found our evidence.
She saw it firsthand.
He's guilty!
Good enough for me?
Me too.
So that's it, right?
Calm down the witching well.
Nah, that's too fucking easy for a crook like that.
What do you mean?
He's gotta pay for what he did.
Listen to yourselves!
You're all rats, fleeing from one sinking ship to the next. So quick to latch onto whatever will keep your miserable lives afloat. This is how you want to repay all I've done for you.
What, you take two people's lives away and now you want mercy?
You know we can't let you go free after this.
Wait!
You're done talking, Crooked Man. You had your chance.
Well done, then.
Now, for your sentence.
We don't have to become murderers.
What are you talking about?
He's guilty. I know that, but we don't have to kill anybody. We can imprison him. Lock him up forever. Somewhere he can never hurt anyone again.
How can we be sure he won't escape?
I can help. We'll use magic.
That's not good enough.
Maybe there will be more if he isn't stopped.
Hasn't there been enough
bloodshed? So we get rid of him.
It's too dangerous.
We can send him away.
Everyone, listen up. Clearly, we're having trouble agreeing on a suitable punishment, so I think
this is going nowhere.
Someone needs to make a decision.
Who?
I hope you aren't suggesting yourself.
Why not?
What about a vote?
What do you think this is?
Everyone, calm down.
We should have a vote. Make it democratic.
Do you really think that's going to work?
He's right. Nobody can agree on anything. What about Bigby? What about him?
He was appointed. He's the only official representative, really. He should be the judge.
That makes sense to me.
I guess it does.
Okay.
Fine.
Are you sure? This isn't how
it's... It's what the people want, Miss White.
Okay. Mr. Wolf, it's your call.
Snow.
Just do what you think is right.
Yes, Sheriff. Do what you think is right.
Teach him a fucking lesson.
No.
He has to die.
We can lock him
just
away.
Just fucking get rid of him.
Not this way.
There you are. I hope you all remember this moment. Think of me. When you try to sleep. Finish it, Sheriff.
Please, we can still...
End it already. You know, just between us, I was gonna let you live. But now...
You're going to miss me.
No, I won't.
For Lily and Faith.
Yes, another one of us to erase from the books.
Hey, Sheriff. Are you gonna come see the truck off? We're leaving for the farm in a few. Thought you might want to. I don't know.
I'll be down in a minute.
Okay. Great.
This fucking line.
Mr. Wolf, Flycatcher left his keys.
Is everything okay? You look...
I'm sorry, Sheriff. I have to take care of this. We'll talk later, okay?
Good morning, Miss White.
You're late.
Someone's gonna see you, Colin.
I'm going! Jesus!
We only have like 5 minutes.
And carry me for fuck's sake! I don't give a shit!
You forgot these.
Oh, thank you. It's been pretty busy around here.
Morning, Sheriff. Nice fucking day. Shit! Just go grab that, would you?
Sorry about all this. I tried to help.
Just why the hell did she have to send me and me boy away, huh? You promised me I'd get another chance. But Miss White said I had to go up to the damn farm anyway. I told her I had the money, but she didn't want to hear it.
Wait, Sheriff Bigby. I have something.
You know, he was up crying all night, poor kid.
Can you give this to Miss White, please? Dad says there's no time to say goodbye, so... If you could bring it to her, she was nice. So...
Yeah, sure.
I couldn't take them all with me, and she said she liked that one the best. It's a willow beetle. That's a big one. They're cool, because when they're little, they have these pouches that squirt juice at you if you touch them.
I'm sure she'll love it.
She said it was pretty.
We're about ready to head out.
What's it like at the farm? I've heard ogres live there, and they eat people in their sleep sometimes.
God, I hope not.
Do we have to go? I want to stay here.
Well, we don't have a choice anymore.
Don't worry. You'll be a lot safer there. There's plenty of space to run around, and a nice river nearby, so you can swim all you want.
Even in daytime?
Yeah, you don't have to worry about the Mundi seeing you. It'll be nice. Come on, it won't be so bad.
Have you been there before?
No. Some of the animals aren't comfortable around wolves.
So you wouldn't know, would you?
We're all set.
Bye, Mr. Wolf.
Goodbye, TJ.
Hey, Bigby. Where's your friend, Colin? Where's the fucking pig?
How should I know?
Saying goodbye?
Hi.
Hi.
You're still wearing that thing.
Oh, yeah. I guess I am. It's not easy to forget. I know it seems like I should be able to. It's just...
It's okay. I get it.
Listen, I came here because I have to tell you something.
What is it?
It's about what happened to Faith and Lily. Not sure where to start. Faith, Lily, and I, we had this plan. We were gonna find a way out. Leave the pudding and pie for good. But then Faith decided to get some leverage. She stole a picture of Crane and Lily together. The minute Faith stole that photo, we had dirt on one of the Crooked Man's allies. If he found out, I had no choice. You have to understand. You've seen how they kept us quiet in that place. Can you imagine the lengths they'd go just to silence someone who had physical evidence? I had to.
Marissa, what did you do?
I freaked out, okay? I thought if I came clean to Georgie, he'd get the Crooked Man to leave us alone. We could just forget the whole thing. Maybe try again in a few years.
You what?
So I told him everything. And I begged for mercy for all of us. I didn't want anyone to die over a picture.
You were just trying to protect them.
Yeah. Georgie promised he'd smooth things over with the Crooked Man. But then... Oh, God.
Here.
Thank you. I don't know what happened, but that night at the club, Georgie came back and told me things had changed. He had to make an example of us. We had committed treason. And while the two of us were sitting there, as he was telling me this, Faith walked in, and I had to watch while Georgie...
Wait, so Georgie told you all this, not the Crooked Man? Back at the well, you said...
I know what I said.
But it wasn't the truth, was it?
What does it matter? I know the Crooked Man did it. So what if it wasn't the whole truth? It was true enough.
I guess what's done is done.
I know he ordered their deaths. I wasn't gonna let him get away with it because of a stupid technicality. Especially after... That night, after Faith, I tried to warn Lily, but she wasn't with her scheduled appointment. So I did the only thing I could do. I left Faith's head at your doorstep.
You?
I walked her over here, and I left her. Just hoping that maybe if I couldn't save them, could at least save the rest of us.
So that piece of fabric I found near there, that was you?
Yeah, I cut my leg trying to get over the fence.
So you started all this?
I just pointed you in the right direction. People like us get forgotten all the time. The Crooked Man was counting on that. When we suffer, we do it in silence. And the world likes it that way. We just fade like we never existed. I couldn't watch that happen to Faith or Lily. Nobody cares about us. Not really.
I'm sorry, Narissa. I'm sorry that's what it took to get me to pay attention.
It'll be different now. You'll make things right. You and Snow.
I don't know. Seems like no matter what I do, it's just not enough for her or anyone. I just can't win with these people.
I know it might feel that way, but... they need you, Bigby. Both of you. You two make a good team. The way you look out for each other and look out for us. You don't see that a lot these days.
I don't really know where we stand anymore. Things are just different.
Huh. Things are always different. Look, Bigby. After everything you've done for us, maybe they don't want to admit it, but without you... none of this would have happened. You listened when no one else would. You protected your friends, no matter the cost. And you brought justice to this town, finally. Because you brought the Crooked Man in, everyone saw who he really was.
So from where I'm standing, you did the right thing. You've been given this job for a reason. And I left Faith at your doorstep because I knew if anyone stood a chance against the Crooked Man, it was you.
I hope I've at least done some good here.
You've changed this place. For better or worse, Fabletown wouldn't be the same without you. You're not as bad as everyone says you are.
I need to tell you something.
I have to tell you something.
I feel like we've met before.
You're trying to place me.
You like my ribbon?
Do you like it?
Faith wore one too.
Would hide her beauty so she could escape his kingdom.
They used to call me the Little Mermaid.
Did Dr. Swinehart ever get back to you about Faith?
He said he wanted to run more tests. I hope you find what you're looking for.